Hi, and welcome to Vitalio. I'm Dr. Ben Lerner. We're in a series on patient management, and today we're going to cover how to work smarter, not harder. That sounds like a good idea. This is with Dr. Todd Osborne. Let's get started.
So I wanted to speak to you for a few minutes about working smarter, not harder. So I have always had the belief that working hard is a great principle in life. And so there's no doubt about that. I'm all about working hard, being as productive as possible. And that's where the key to this comes in, is being productive as possible doesn't always mean just grinding harder into it and working harder, if you will. And so when we talk about working smarter, not harder, what that really means is, what can you do to be more efficient, to be more productive, to be more profitable in either less time or less effort on your part? And what you can find is, once you build efficiency into your practice, then we follow that with proficiency. Proficiency leads to productivity, and productivity leads to ultimately profitability, which we all have to do to run a successful business, correct? So most people are looking for the keys and the secrets to profitability, productivity, and many times they think, if I just work harder at it, if I just spend more hours at it, if I just grind a little more on it, then that will lead to the productivity and profitability. But the principle is that all of that comes first from efficiency. And so you must have efficiency first, and that's the smarter part. The smarter you are, the more efficiency you have, then ultimately the less work or less effort or less time that it takes you to get to the productivity and profitability. So I want to talk to you a little bit today about just a few subjects of the many on working harder, not smarter in your practice. So number one is your systems. Do you even have a system? And when I talk about system, I'm talking about your protocols, your procedures in your office for you as a doctor and for your staff members. Because without a system, I promise you, you have efficiency breakdowns. And as soon as you have the efficiency breakdowns, now you're working harder, not smarter. So do you have that system? Do you have a system for your consultation, your examinations, your reports of findings, your education of your patients, for your care plan for your patients? Do you have systems at your front desk, with your therapy CA, with your other CAs, what they're doing in the office? Do they have a protocol and procedures to follow that can make them as efficient as possible? So efficiency just allows us to accomplish more in less effort and less amount of time. So again, that's working smarter. Your daily office visits, do you have a system for that? Or is everything just shoot from the hip in your office and you feel like you're running around putting out fires all day? And, oh, this needs attention, that needs attention. Oh, this person has a question, this staff member needs help with this, this staff member has a question about this. So first and foremost on working smarter is to make sure you have systems in place and the training that goes with that. So you should be being trained, doctors. Your staff members should be being trained, whether that's by you or other coaches or other people that are consulting and helping you with your practice and managing your staff and training your staff. So that's number one. Number two that I want to share with you today is setting your office up properly. Do you have the proper setup in your office, number one, just for your efficiency, working, your patient flow, you as a doctor, how you flow through the office, and your staff members? I had a practice early on in my career where I had two adjusting rooms and they were on the opposite ends of the building. So I was spending half my day running up and down the hallway in between there. Then I developed an office and built an office that I was able to work out of one room. So I was able to see hundreds of patients a week working out of one room. So that was very efficient for me. And I was able to see many, many patients there with less effort and in less time because I had eliminated all the time that was going up and down the hallway each and every day.
Hey, we'll be right back with the rest of this material. But as a reminder, check the description for links to our podcast, YouTube channel, upcoming webinars, and other ways to get our contact regularly. I want to share this quick story with you really briefly from a doctor who has worked with Vitalio, and then we'll get right back to the content.
Hi, my name is Dr. David Landers. I practice in the area of Alabama. About a year ago, I started on a mission to work smarter instead of harder. I set out to change that by increasing my collection visit average, or CVA. So I implemented a couple of different strategies when increasing my CVA. At the time, I was at about $46 per patient visit. So the strategies I decided to implement were going majority private pay, nutrition, and testing. So over the last year, we've been able to increase our CVA from $46 to $78. What has impressed me the most by this process is that patients are actually much more committed to their care. When you're taking their care more seriously, you attract patients who value their health. And our office has just been blown away by the results that we've been able to achieve with these patients and the patient satisfaction.
I had a practice early on in my career where I had two adjusting rooms and they were on the opposite ends of the building. So I was spending half my day running up and down the hallway in between there. Then I developed an office and built an office that I was able to work out of one room. So I was able to see hundreds of patients a week working out of one room. So that was very efficient for me. And I was able to see many, many patients there with less effort and in less time because I had eliminated all the time that was going up and down the hallway each and every day. The other thing to think about is your patient flow. Are you waiting on patients? Are they having to come up and down the hallways? Does it not flow well? Is the therapy area not set up or the resting area not set up correctly so that that flow can be efficient for you? And your staff members also, are they set up where they can be as efficient as possible? And that may be having your front desk close to the therapy area so that they are able to efficiently serve both of those areas in your office. So there's many, many things that it can come into play with that. But I know over the years, from setting up offices to be as efficient as possible so they can be productive and profitable, that I've seen one chair moved in the office to the proper place allowed this doctor and his staff to increase that practice by $10,000 a month. So I would say that's being much smarter instead of working harder, right? And by moving one chair, it took about 30 seconds to do that, and it increased profitability by $10,000 a month. The third thing I want to talk about is educating your patients. And when I say educating your patients, that means a lot of things to a lot of people in the chiropractic world. But not only educating them on what chiropractic is and what chiropractic is about, but to work smarter, not harder, you want to educate your patients so they can make intelligent choices in your office. So you just want to keep working harder? Just keep trying to sell them. Just keep trying to convince them that chiropractic is what they need. And again, that's not only working harder, but that's frustrating. and that gets old after a while. And that's many of the complaints I hear from other chiropractors is I feel like I'm selling all the time. I'm so tired of feeling like a used car salesman. So how do we work smarter and not harder with that? Well, the first thing you've got to realize is that everyone wants to buy, but no one wants to be sold. I'll say that one more time. Everyone wants to buy, but no one wants to be sold. So how do we work smarter with this? Well, again, it's back to your system that you have to give the patients the knowledge they need to make the correct decision. So they're not just basing their decision on money. They're not just basing their decision on their pain or being out of pain. They understand their health, the problem that they have, and what needs to be done to correct that. And if you can do that, you're going to have a lot less energy and effort put forward because they are making the decision, because then they want to buy. They understand the need that they have. They understand the product that you have in your office that can help them, that can make a difference in their health moving forward. So these are just three of dozens, hundreds of things that you can do in your office to work smarter and not harder. And then that's up to you. Maybe it's just to be more productive. You want to be more efficient. You want to work smarter so that you can go from seeing 50 or 100 or 150 patient visits a week to seeing 300, 400, 500 patient visits a week. Maybe it's you want to work less, so you want to stay right where you're at 300 patient visits a week, and you say, you know what, I would like to do that, but instead of working 4.5 or 5 days a week to do that, what if I could do that in 3 days, 3.5 days, 2.5 days a week to have that productivity? That's working smarter, not harder. So I appreciate your time today. I hope this helps you. And please let me know if you need any more help on figuring out how to work smarter, not harder.
Hey, thanks for joining us today. As a reminder, we've got regular webinars that go into even more detail on this topic. Check the description for more ways to get our content and sign up. If you'd like more information about Vitalio and how it might help your practice, you can always reach us at vitaliohealth.com. That's VitalioHealth.com. Bless you, and remember who you are.